Department, like I said, with the Social Security Act, they provide a benefit to me sometime, maybe when I'm 60, 70, 80, 90. They change it all the time. Why? Because I'm not the trustor. I didn't create it. So I can't say when I'm allowed to start getting benefits on the Social Security Act. But if you're trying to hand me a present, if you're trying to hand me a Social Security number and say, well, this is my benefit, but it's going to cause me harm or pain somewhere along the way, well, then I don't have to accept something that's going to cause me harm or pain, because I'm not the creator of this monster. I'm not the creator of this Frankenstein. You are. Get this Frankenstein off my back. And that's what I'm saying. People don't realize that's what the book Frankenstein is about. It's Mary Shelley. Her mom was like the first law professor in Oxford, and her dad was like the highest magistrate in England. And all Frankenstein is shows the how a corporation exists within a society. If you let a corporation get out of control, how it can cause harm to man and mankind. So Frankenstein has nothing to do about a monster. If you really study Mary Shelley and Mary Shelley's mom and Mary Shelley's dad, you would say, holy cow, Frankenstein is a book based upon corporations.
Really? So it's another one of those Wizard of Oz type deals, right?
But
where it has a whole different meaning than what you thought.
Exactly. So if you want to think it's a monster movie, enjoy. I'm sorry I spoiled it for you. But it's really about how man brings a corporate entity into society and the ability that a corporate entity has.
It creates a monster.
And it creates a monster. It depends. Something could go wrong. He had the best intents. The intentions to do the right thing. Who knew? Shit. Stuff happens and, you know, you get a monster in your hands. Now what are we going to do? You know, we're going to round him up and kill him. You know,
we gotta
put him down. We gotta revoke his charter. So like I said, when you actually say, wow, Mary Shelley's mom was like the first law professor in Oxford, you know, Cambridge, well, no, 1780, wow. And her mom,
say that again, slower and close to the mic, because I didn't understand a word you said.
No, I'm just repeating myself about who Mary Shelley's mom
Mary.
Was.
Yeah, was she?
I said, like I said, she was like the first law professor, female, who was like a teacher or professor in Oxford or Cambridge. And her dad was like the highest magistrate, like in the chancellor. He was like the highest chancellor, whatever, in England at the time as well. So her mom and dad would explain to her, like, corporate and how corporate society and corporate law, and she turned it into a book. And she's like, let's make a corporate monster who's going to, you know, terrorize, and if you leave, he's out of control, and they're going to terrorize the society, and oh my God, and all chaos and mayhem could happen. So she made it entertaining. She could have made a law legal book and everybody would have been bored out of their mind. She'd probably like, look, we got 10,000 of those sitting on a shelf and nobody reads them. Hey, let's make it into a monster in the book. And oh boy, everybody will love reading this. This is the way I